I have been dreading making this video for a very long time. Hi everyone, my name is Erin and today I'm bringing you a little bit of a different video for my channel. I'm going to be talking about why I'm no longer shopping at Macy's and share with you my last Macy's beauty box.
Ooh,
the tea is hot, so go get some. If you would like to see why I don't shop at Macy's anymore, please keep watching. Let's start with unboxing my last Macy's beauty bag. And then we'll go from there. So I'm not gonna read all of them like I normally do, but I'm just gonna go through them. So the first thing I see is $10 off a beauty purchase. We'll address this later, why I think it's $10 and not $5. So the first thing I have in here is a little Chanel perfume. It smells nice. Perfume samples usually go to my mom. I have a little Their Real mascara. I will keep that. I have a little Radiant Yellow MAC Prep and Prime Primer. This will go in the giveaway box. Ooh, the Lancome Lash Primer. I will keep that. I have a little Tarte Bestie lip paint. I think I already have this one, so probably the giveaway box. And a little Blotterazzi Pro. That's going to go in the giveaway box. All right, so now that that's all out of the way, let's talk. So this all started on October 21st. I'm filming this video on November 18th, so we are a month later. On October 21st, MAC had a sale for brushes, 50% off all brushes at Macy's. I had placed an order for 2 brushes. At 4 o'clock in the morning, I woke up for these brushes. I had placed an order for a 242 and a 239. Okay, cool, no problem. So first thing is, that day I get an email saying that my order is going to be split into 2 shipments. Okay, no problem. Probably coming from 2 different warehouses. I then get an email about another 6 hours later stating that the brush, the 239, was discontinued and that I would be getting a refund. Okay, cool. No problem. That's what I thought. So, long story short, it's now November 18th and I still haven't gotten my refund for the other brush. I first called about a week later and they're saying, oh, well, you used your PayPal. It'll take a little bit of extra time than normal. And then I called again and they said, oh, well, it's going to go through. It's a refund. It's still pending. I am here on November 18th, a month later. That is a pending Macy's charge from October 21st. So the full $21 of both brushes, not just the one that I paid for. The customer service was so rude to me. They kept telling me, oh, well, you'll get it back later. You'll get it back later, whatever. It's just, I'm just so appalled that a month later and it's $11. It's not the money. Right now it's the principal. I want my money back. I paid for something that I did not get and I was offered a 30% off coupon for my inconvenience. No. All right, let's move on to my next thing. So I had taken my beauty box coupon one day to my local Macy's, the little coupon they give you, to the MAC counter. And they flat out told me, no, we don't accept them here. I called corporate and they said, yeah, you're supposed to take them to any counter. Like, you can use them there, no big deal. So why are they telling people they can't use a coupon that they're supposed to? But that's like the small thing. Let's keep going. So I don't know if you guys remember, but about a couple weeks ago, the Benefit Gimme Brow was discontinued. And we had received a Benefit Gimme Brow in a box 2 months ago. And Sephora Play and a bunch of other subscription boxes were issuing refunds because of this was in the box. When I tried to ask them about that, they said, no, there's no recall. There's nothing wrong. It's fine. It's fine. There's nothing wrong. It's just was in the box. That is why I personally think that they gave $10 in this box instead of the last one. And then after all of this, I tried to cancel my box and they make it impossible to cancel your box because I'm not impressed with it. It's just not that big of a deal, whatever. And they made it impossible and they were like, well, are you sure trying to offer me coupons and not listening to me as a consumer saying I want to cancel my box. So I finally did cancel it. This is my last one. And then I also canceled my Macy's credit card because I was so frustrated with the company. This is going to be going to one of my friends because I refuse to shop there anymore. Long story short, I never got a refund from about a month ago. They're trying to tell me that a product that was discontinued, that was never discontinued, and didn't want to issue me a refund for that, It made it impossible for me to get off the subscription service, and they're mistelling employees about the coupons in the subscription service. So, yes. That is why I am no longer shopping at Macy's. This is just my personal experience. I don't like making videos like this. I don't think I ever made a video like this, but I just wanted to let you guys know my personal experience and what happened to me. If you've ever had any bad experiences with Macy's, let me know in the comments down below. Some people will probably say that this is just a series of unfortunate events, but I personally think a month later I should be issued my money back. Thank God PayPal is as good as it is, because I can see like the authorizations and stuff. So, that is why I do not shop at Macy's anymore. Have a great day, everyone. I will see you in my next video. Subscribe if you haven't already, and use kind, use smart, use important. Bye!